And of course, welcome back from that very short break. We are still up and today taking you all the way to 11 a.m. this morning. And we are going to be talking taboo. We are going to be twisting your minds, especially the ladies. If you're a lady out there and you're one of them who believes marriage probably defines you, or better yet, you are headed towards marriage. This is a conversation you, ooh, child, you need to.
Child of God.
Get your cup of coffee. Sit down. There's three women on set, and we are going to be talking about something that pretty much bugs everyone. And not just everyone, every woman finding out that, well, perhaps this wasn't
better
meant
not be
for
my
me.
Story because
it was mine. Trust me, it was mine. So in studio, I have none other than Grace Linda. She's a counselor. She's going to be our muse for today because, well, we're using her mind because she wrote something that tickled our fancy. And Pap Mother is also in the building. Good morning, Grace.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm good. Thank you for having me.
It's a pleasure. We've been dying to actually
what do, you do
this.
Do, Grace? What do you do?
I'm a counselor and motivational speaker.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Yeah. I've been thinking about entering that line of work. Is it paying? Is it
don't you carry some of the problems with yourself?
No.
It's part of that job. Somehow.
I thought you were supposed to be emotionally
devoted. Like when you break down,
I'd make a good counselor because I'm emotionally unavailable.
You're unavailable. You're detached.
Yes. Tell me your problems, I'll solve them, walk out, I won't remember them.
Yes, when you break down, who do you go to?
When I break down?
When you break down.
My mother.
Oh yeah, she has a support system.
Yes.
But anyway, let us not dilly-dall on it anymore. So you went to social media and you brought up a scenario. Now in this scenario, you actually said, my 11-year-old courtship that didn't amount to marriage.
Yes.
Now keep in mind, ladies and gentlemen, that this is not her story, but better yet, she sat down and wrote it from a perspective that I think most of us can
resonate
with. Now, she talked about this guy, they were together, right?
Yeah.
They were together with this chick, they have been cohabiting. They were girlfriend and boyfriend for
quite some time.
Supported each other. Mm-hmm. And then she had this dream of like, oh my goodness, when he finishes graduation, we're going to be together, we're going to get married. Mm-hmm. Throughout the entire campus time, she was that pushing force, being there for him, ride or die, Bonnie and Clyde. Then after that, he finishes campus, the promises are still there, right?
Yeah.
Because that's all you've
got. The hope is still there, the faith is still there.
Yes, now after campus, they get the first job, she's working too. Mm-hmm. Things seems to be like
they're
falling
in
into place. Yeah, like everything seems like it's going perfectly. Mm-hmm. And then she's waiting for the proposal that never happened. Now, all throughout that, he is promising her, yes, the proposal will come. Yes, I love you. He's building houses, he's building for his
family.
And she is believing. Now,
and she's praying. God, women can pray for this.
I know. Now, here's the fun bit. After 11 years, it all never amounted to much.
To anything.
Now, I know as a woman, I'm going to say, I say this coming from a place of understanding, because the very first time when I walked away from my marriage, the first question I asked myself was like,
wait, the very first time?
Yes.
So you've walked away how many times?
No. As in,
she just woke up
like,
one morning
when I woke up and
I
said, I'm done. And I walked away. The very first time I actually thought about me walking away, the question I had in my mind was, 15 years?
Oh, God.
15. And then it made me understand, when I read this letter, it hit me, struck a chord, because when I was with my ex, not to take anything away from him, because, you know, that's the father of my kids.
Yes.
I can't disrespect him without disrespecting his offspring.
Yeah.
But when you're in love and then school comes in, there's nothing as beautiful as that blind hope.
Mm.
I kept my hope for 15 years.
You know, Derek was asking before he went off. Meanwhile, for those who are wondering why Derek isn't here, Derek has a stomach problem. We do not know what he ate. And I'm sorry, I did not tell you. So when he comes here, just act like you.
And I was hoping Derek would be here.
He is going to come.
Derek asked, the first question he asked, 11 years, what are you still doing in a marriage?
Please,
after 4 years, what
it,
are you still thinking?
This is a courtship, please not.
Yeah, it's not even
Okay. He said, 11 years, you're cohabiting with a man. What are you still doing even after 4 years?
By the way, this was not cohabiting because he didn't let it happen.
Yeah, he never let her move into the house. Even
every time
finished
she moved
the house,
a few things into the house,
she would find them packed. But it's been 11 years though.
Yeah.
Oh, first, explain that scenario. How did that even pop
just
up?
Just make us understand how that man thinks.
Okay,
maybe
this is
there's
what
a
happens.
Reason.
This story is bits and pieces of other people's
stories.
Yeah. What they go through. Yeah. Mm-hmm. thinking of painting a picture and building a castle and staying hopeful, yes, mm-hmm. while missing out all the red flags and leaving out the realistic expectations of what exactly you want, what exactly you expect, and just, I don't know, staying in your own bubble, creating a world that is not there.
Being in a bubble.
Grace, this is what I'm going to ask. Uh-huh. Can we say that we have changed a lot of the present by ignoring the past? Why? Because there is a way a girl had to go to a man for marriage. Is it
way.
That now, the girl takes herself to the man.
To the man.
No longer does the man go to the girl's home and pick up the girl.
I think it is in such a way that people have made it so easy or even it's no longer the conventional
way,
the conservative. I actually appreciated the conservative way of doing things because there your parents were in the thing with you. They actually, for some people, they were betrothed, like they would identify a suitable person
from when you were
for
little.
You from when you were little, like this family, their background, their history, their what, their relationship. Now it's all about me and you. Do I love you? But the question is, do you love me back?
Who holds me accountable?
Who holds me accountable to this love?
If I don't do
and where
right
is it going? Yeah? Anyway.
Let me ask you a very serious question, because this is something that I know there's a woman out there seated in a situationship that she understands, because I don't call these relationships. I call them situationships. Yes. She's in a situationship. She doesn't know if she should stay because hope teaches us, you know, they say hope is the last man to die. If you lose hope, you're dead. So she doesn't want to leave. But then again, she's seeing the red flags. And then again, society is throwing it in her face. You can't just walk away after investing in that much time. What would be the very first thing you tell a woman like that?
Well, I have learned that, I keep telling people that, okay, while everything is happening, like I'm invited to speak at bridal showers, basically to tell you, I'm not the typical singer of, I'm not going to talk about sex, no. I'm going to talk about things like that matter, that like effective communication.
True.
Understanding your partner's love language, the power of a praying partner, how to deal with a cheating partner, like all these things. Meanwhile, this is all preparing you for the end, But I keep telling people, choose to marry right.
Ooh,
but there's
that.
No book that says marry right.
Wait,
what
let
is marry
her
right?
explain her marry right. Wama, what is
I keep telling
right?
people, choose to marry right. This is how. I got to speak to different people, and I was asking, the person you're with right now, would you marry them? That was a question. And I can tell you that 3/4 of those people said no. And I was wondering, okay.
Then why are you with them?
Why are you with them? And for the guys, the biggest part was, for now, it works. It works.
If
she can cook.
Don't fix it.
She can cook. The sex is okay. I'm not complaining. And for the ladies, it was like, he gives me money.
He looks after me.
He's like an entrepreneur. He's good. He's okay. For now, it works. But would you marry them? Would you choose this person? Yeah?
Why is
Derek
coming over
the set? Like, Derek Muraba, he just can't help
he
it.
He is dying.
Calm, Derek. No, Derek, stop quoting the Bible. Did you confess your sins?
If you don't mind it, you just do like this and look at me. Because I have this question I want to ask you. I want to go back to the letter this morning. 11 years of courtship, right?
He's coming right here.
Yeah.
11 years of courtship, and, you know, this lady is sticking around and trying to be the woman that, you know, she wants to be. She wants the ring, and, you know, she's not getting it because the man is literally fed up. Every time she brings clothes home, the man packs them, and, you know.
He wasn't, like, really fed up. He wasn't decided. He was not ready. Commitment issue.
How, as a man, because there are very many right there who are going through this kind of problem, and I would like to use your expertise at this point in time to explain to them what is the best way of telling a woman that, madam,
it's not going to happen.
I am not ready. It is not going to happen.
Now, I have understood the fact that over time, men do not actually use words. They are not expressive.
They are not.
That is what we need to understand as women. Men are not expressive. They are more practical than we are. We use the words. we use the words like, it's not you, it's me.
I'm not feeling this.
I don't love you anymore. You have changed. Men, on the other hand, will
He'll
not
show
tell
you.
That change is his communication.
You. Yes.
Guys, I asked Grace.
We are trying to understand your head. Understanding your slow head.
Your question is actually to the women.
No, to
how
the man.
Do we
to the men.
To
no,
the men. It is to the women. How should they interpret this practicality that men are showing them?
What we call the change.
The change. Because this man is not going to come and say, you know what,
I'm
not ready. I'm done with this. I have moved on. It's not working. He will not.
But you see, all the confusing thing, Grace, is even when he says he's not ready,
you
walk away
it.
And then he will come after you and then you'll keep going back. So basically it's a, I pick you, you go back. I pick you, you go back. You understand? It's that endless cat
you
and
know,
mouse
for,
game.
For men, I think they're more objective than we are.
Very
and
right.
We are more subjective than we are. I'm sorry to say.
It's the truth.
Don't apologize.
Because for a man, if the sex is okay,
true.
Yeah,
mm.
He practical may not feel being. Like changing it. The bits and pieces that matter to him. Because for the men, the most important things in
are
order
physical.
Are respect, number one,
that's
sex,
true.
And then the food.
Food.
RSF.
That's very true.
Finished.
That's very
yeah?
True.
So if those work, the first set.
And for
things.
The woman, what is it?
Ah, femulina bindi.
There's so much.
Grace, continue. I'm in charge.
Yes. So the first set.
By the way.
Okay.
For the first set for the men, those that work, for him it will work and it will be okay. And there will not be
even
any
if
need
it's 20 years.
To, even if it's 20 years.
It works.
For right now, if that is what works for him, it's all right. And for us, we want more. And the question is, I think, is, why do women want more than what is already working?
Exactly. So
we
I
get
got a
bored.
Problem with that.
I get bored.
I'm sorry, give me tip to you off from my question, but you are trying to explain to me the practical bit. Men are not expressive.
They are practical.
And you know, they're more of a
practical.
Doing
you just
this and then that's it. They're not good with their wives. So as women, how are we as men supposed to twist all this around to make sure that the women, get the message that they're supposed to get.
Open your damn mouth.
Open your damn
mouth.
I think you have to constantly, I keep telling people that adults learn by example. Yeah? If you keep talking to me, in Luganda is akacha mama meda, we keep hoping that we're going to change you together kubaga maybe gambo we know. I keep telling you these things and they will change you. On the other hand, if a man is set in his ways, he will not change.
True.
If this is what he wants, Kati, how do you get the woman to understand? I guess you have to just keep doing, showing, until they finally
but to
get
what
it.
Extent?
This
but
woman
see,
proving yourself
was being shown until she realized that she wasted 11 years of her life. Would you blame the man for that?
Yes.
Why?
I think.
Linda Cortina.
Yes.
Would you blame the man for that?
Mine is yes and no.
I think yes and no. I'm with her.
Let's begin
True.
With yes. Why would you blame the man?
I blame the man because he kept hoping, he kept promising.
Yeah, that.
And saying,
I
never
did that. That there is where I hold
and
them
saying,
down.
Saying something like, you know what? After I get my mom land,
definitely. We're doing
you're,
this.
You're next.
So,
you're
that man, this man
you
in
keep
particular.
Waiting.
And then that was.
No,
out
this
of,
man in particular was vile. The fact
yes.
that. He kept on saying,
he kept
what
her
if
on
he's
a leash.
Not saying?
He kept on a leash. He kept promising, after this, it's you. After that,
you're
it's
always
you.
There.
So
you're always
there
on a leash. There.
Yeah. And actually, most of these things do make sense when they are justified, that they are valid. His reasons are
valid.
Yeah.
Sure.
And then you're like, okay, it makes sense. His
Let me wait for the house.
Let me wait for the house. Let me. And it all makes sense. It all fits.
And
in.
You know, Grace, that is the reason why now we have women. We have women who are over 40, and there is no man. They, as in, just leave the man. Okay, it isn't like, oh, when you get married, that is a degree you've gotten. It's more like you have kept your career on hold, yet you could have gone on and lived your life. But you're holding on for a guy who keeps coming back to
I
you
blame
with
them.
A reason that, oh, everything is going to be okay. After this, we're going to do you. After
I
this, we're going
them.
To do you. So now, here is my question. Who is to blame? With the broken families today. Why broken? Because it is broken from head to toe, isn't it?
Can I answer that?
Okay.
Before she even does. One, there are very many people to blame for the broken homes. One, the number one biggest emphasis of why we have broken homes is because we ourselves came from homes that were dysfunctional
okay.
but looked functional.
I take that. Okay.
If your mother was the type that would cover up what's on the inside and never outrightly say it.
Yeah.
You grew up that way. If your father was the guy who drove inside the gate and everyone ducks for cover, you grew up that way. Now look at the girls coming from those homes or the boys coming from those homes. It's that simple. But let us first move from the broken family. You know, we're talking about hope because the way this letter ended, you said you need to understand marriage is not for everyone. Marriage is not your standing in life. Marriage should not define you or anything like that. But what do you tell a girl right now who has been waiting?
For 11 years.
No, not 11 years. It could even be as small as 6 months. But that is her hope. Should we blame it on society or should we blame it on the girls?
No, I keep thinking that... first of all, people should stop looking at marriage as an achievement.
It is not. Thank you. I am not married.
What is marriage? It is a stage in your life. That if this stage does not come through at the same age every other person expects, it's okay.
It's perfectly fine.
Yeah? And then when I bring in the marry right thing, I asked someone and they told me, ask them, you know, you have a good job, you have already built, you come from a good family, I know you. Yes, I could vouch for you. Yes. What is it? Why don't you have this girl? Why don't you have this wife? And this is what he told me. He said, I have to marry right. And I asked him to actually explain what this meant for him. And he said, every other person is marrying for every other person.
I'm marrying for me.
I have to move out of home, so you should marry me. Like, let's move in because I have to leave home. That's for the girl.
Okay.
For the man, my mom is about to, she's aged, and I want to give her grandbabies. And yes, it makes sense.
Selfish reasons.
Yeah? And all those things are for society.
True.
Yeah? Everyone around me is
not
getting
for
married.
You.
All my friends. But how about you marry right for you? What do you want? Why do you want it?
My last question, guys, before we get to wrap up, I'm sure Gina is about to call for a break. Depending, given the stats you just gave us about 3/4 of men who you asked, if they will marry the person they are with currently and they say no, what are some of the things that you need to put into consideration as a man for you to come up with a decision that this is the woman that I want to marry?
Derek wants to marry.
Asking for himself.
Jesus, Derek is going to make someone's way.
The food and the respect. What are the things that you need to look forward to before you actually say, you know what, I need to get on one knee?
Okay. First of all, you have to understand yourself. You have to be self-aware and the things that are important to you as a man. Your individuality comes before anything else.
That's true.
Yes, okay. Your individuality. What do you want and why do you want it? And what can this person bring to the table for you?
Right.
It is very important. And then after that, apart from this love thing, because it will definitely go
out
of the window.
It does. It does.
Is this person your friend? Can you actually, can you relate with them on a higher level that is past this love, butterfly things?
Yeah,
because
have an high-level language.
Yeah? Friendship goes beyond that. Can you communicate with this person? Can they understand your communication? Because actually, effective communication. Why? Because communication, I could talk to you and you're not getting my message.
True.
Why?
Yeah.
I'm not clear, my language, my
lost
accent,
in translation.
My anything. And then people have to, under this communication, people have to learn to talk to each other, not to talk at. Most people listen, most people talk
at.
At. Yeah?
Not
and then
to.
We listen to talk back, not to comprehend.
With.
Okay.
Yeah?
Well done.
Would I be wrong to say that it's okay for women to get contract babies without being attached to any man?
No, now you're wrecking the
contract
babies.
Yeah.
Like
we meet, all we need is the baby and we're done. No promises, no nothing.
You know,
you're
with women,
broken
it goes beyond that.
Okay.
While you think that this is what you want, women are full of feelings.
Too many
feelings. So this is what you want now. But after you conceive this baby, then you'll have expectations. Then you'll blame the man for not meeting them. But then you had.
Meaning,
so I would not support it.
Another one. I know Derek does this finger when he's saying, why now?
Yeah, we need to.
So
wind up.
I'm also asking,
right now,
since it seems like a wedding and a marriage is a reward to the woman, is it okay Is it supposed to be a reward? Like, should women beg the men to marry them?
No.
Girls, have some pride about
you.
You
should.
Pride.
You know, there is something that I call value upon your head.
Mm. Thank you.
Yeah? Value on your head. This man should want to marry you. You shouldn't make him
marry.
Like, you shouldn't force it. There should not be pressure.
Thank you.
When there is pressure applied, definitely it will not.
Okay, now I'm asking for myself.
Ladies and gentlemen,
let me take us to the version. When we do this back, we still have best in studio, and we shall be using her for the love letter as well.